If you like cheap games and softwares, check out... Let me rephrase that. If you like breeding, check out GVG Mall. Link is in the description. Hey, what's up guys? So today we're gonna talk about the infamous ray tracing. The community is very divided. Some think it's just a money-grabbing gimmick, while others are quite blown away by it and can't wait for the next generation of GPUs, hoping for major improvements. So I know you probably wanna hear on which side am I on, but first I wanna go over what ray tracing actually is and everything you should know about it. But first I wanna say that this video is definitely and unfortunately not sponsored by Nvidia. However, if anyone from Nvidia is watching, hey, sponsor me, would you? No? Damn it! So what is ray tracing? Well, to answer this, I have to first explain rasterization. Both of these are rendering methods. Methods for displaying 3D objects on a 2D screen. Rasterization uses objects created from a mesh of triangles or polygons to represent a 3D model of an object. The rendering pipeline then converts each triangle of the 3D models into pixels on a 2D screen. These pixels may then be further processed or shaded before final display on the screen. This method is very fast and it makes real-time rendering possible. Yes, this is the method all modern games use. In the real world, the 3D objects we see are illuminated by light sources, and photons can bounce from one object to another before reaching the viewer's eyes. Ray tracing provides realistic lighting by simulating the physical behavior of light. Ray tracing calculates the color of pixels by tracing the path that light would take if it were to travel from the eye of the viewer to the virtual 3D scene. As it traverses the scene, the light may reflect from one object to another, causing reflections, be blocked by objects, causing shadows, or pass through transparent or semi-transparent objects, causing refractions. All of these interactions are combined to produce the final color of a pixel, that is then displayed on the screen. And no, Nvidia didn't invent ray tracing. Ray tracing was invented by John Turner Whitted around 1980. Nvidia just figured out a way to do it in real time. And how exactly did they do it? Well, for a start, other GPUs are optimized for rasterization, hence why they perform so much worse than RTX GPUs in ray traced games. RTX 20 series are the first GPUs to be optimized for ray tracing with their RT cores. But there is a big but. All the ray traced games today actually use hybrid rendering rather than being fully ray traced. This means that they only use ray tracing where it gives us most benefits. And also, they only partially use ray tracing. For example, Battlefield 5 uses ray tracing reflections, Shadow of the Tomb Raider uses ray tracing shadows, and so on. So to put in perspective how much processing power ray tracing requires, it wasn't possible even in 3D movies until last decade, because it took too much to render a single frame. And this is even more mind-blowing when you realize that such big projects use render farms. A render farm is simply a collection of computers that work together to render a sequence in less time. Back in 2010, it took 7 hours on average to render a single frame of Toy Story 3. With some frames taking as long as whopping 39 hours. Okay, so yes, this is Quake 2 RTX. What started out as a mod to Quake 2 by Christoph Schied, known as Q2 VKPT, or Quake 2 Vulkan Path Tracing, is now a full standalone release thanks to Nvidia and Lightspeed Studios. All this time you've been watching the gameplay of it without ray tracing enabled. As you can see, I'm getting like around 1000 FPS, but let's enable it now. And now you see major improvements in global illumination, shadows, reflections, and refractions. Since I'm not using an RTX card, but a GTX 1070, I had to change the resolution scale to 50% and global illumination to low. But even then I only get like 40 FPS. Here are the benchmarks if you want to see the difference in performance between GTX and RTX cards. I know what you're probably wondering now, why did I use this game for this video and not something like Battlefield 5 that looks far more stunning? Well, this is the first playable game that's entirely path traced and efficiently simulates fully dynamic lighting in real time, with the same modern techniques as used in the movie industry. Yes, I said path traced and not ray traced. And what is the difference? Well, the author of this project actually explained it very well here, And also I put a link in the description to the video by Disney that explains path tracing very well. So what's my two cents on this? Is this just a gimmick or is it the future of gaming? Well, just look at how much it improved the game that released in 1997. That was 22 years ago. Of course, I don't expect modern games to be fully ray traced or path traced anytime soon, but hybrid rendering is the way to go. And I truly believe it is the future, and I'm really excited to see what's next. Hope you enjoyed this video, feel free to like, subscribe, and also I'm very interested to hear your opinion on this, so make sure to leave a comment down below. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.